Nothing says Christmas like peppermint bark and chocolate, of course. And our next guest has created a way to bake both of those flavors into the perfect holiday cookie. Welcome back the author of the cookie book, Rebecca Firth.
Thanks so much for having me.
Thank you for being here. Of course, we've got amazing, everybody is here because the minute they saw peppermint cookies, they had to belly up to the counter.
They're beautiful, Rebecca.
And Shirley. And now, you know, these just smell so good. And they are so perfect for this time of year. And you have something in your book called the Holiday Cookie Exchange, and these made the cut, so tell me all about it.
So I knew when I was gonna do a cookie book that I needed an entire chapter devoted to holiday baking because it's like the Super Bowl of baking, right? It's all I wanna do. And I love peppermint bark, and I just wanted to create a cookie that kind of deconstructed the flavors and made it into something kind of unique and different. And then we put the yummy peppermint bark flavors on an awesome shortbread, crumbly, buttery, melt-in-your-mouth cookie.
I mean, everything you just said sounds amazing. And I'm watching everybody eat it. Okay, so let's get started. We've got our butter and our sugar already here creamed in the mixer.
Yes.
And how much butter did you say?
So we have 20 tablespoons of butter in there.
And that is why it's so good.
Exactly. Oh, well, that's what makes a shortbread cookie so melt in your mouth, but also crumbly. So you need all that butter. You're grateful for it.
And then what else
then
do we add?
We have one egg yolk, which is going to give us some nice fat, and it's going to make a good cohesive dough.
Because the butter isn't enough fat.
Butter's not enough.
We need more. And then we also have a quarter tablespoon of peppermint extract. You want to be careful with your peppermint extract because if you have too much, it can taste antiseptic or like mouthwash. So like really only do a quarter teaspoon.
Interesting.
Yeah, it can go from holiday to not that great.
To toothpaste.
Yeah. And then we do some vanilla extract. And so we'll run this really quick to mix everything.
Okay.
I've never had a chocolate shortbread cookie.
Really?
No, I've just always had regular shortbread.
That
I didn't even know they
really
existed.
Happy on your first chocolate shortbread.
Yeah, it's delicious.
I mean, you've got a little bit of everything in this cookie, by the way.
Yeah, but I will say the base is only 9 ingredients, which isn't that much, right?
Yeah, so what is the dry?
So the dry ingredients is all-purpose flour, dark cocoa powder, unsweetened, and sea salt, and baking powder.
Oh my gosh, okay. So and so then you would add that into the wet.
Add it into here, but like, you know, you kind of want to be a little careful.
I like, Debbie always has a good trick here where she puts the towel.
I jump with the towel over and just let it go.
Research that. Okay, I'll let you.
I am semi.
So then you mix all that stuff up. Okay, wonderful.
So once we get that all mixed together, we won't go through the whole thing.
Okay, but that all comes together.
And then we're going to separate it into two lumps, right? Okay. And we're going to sculpt them into logs, which is a little challenging because it does have a lot of butter, so it's a soft dough. But you're going to end up with something like this.
And why do you do that exactly?
Well, it's actually a really nice, easy way to make a cookie without, it's kind of like having a sugar cookie, but not. Like, you don't have to roll anything out. So it's a slice and bake.
And to cool it?
Well, you chill it, so it'll hold its shape. Otherwise, when you go to cut it, it would just get mushy and
crumble. So how long does it have to be in the refrigerator?
For about an hour.
That's all.
That's all. And that's not too bad. But you could make these up to a month ahead of time if you wrapped them really tightly and stashed them in there. So then in a month when you're busy and it's the holidays, you're like, olé.
So you put them in the freezer.
Yes.
Or I don't know if they would last that long. You could just eat the cookie dough. Yeah.
That's what I would do. Absolutely. And then, okay, so now we've taken it out of the fridge.
Yes.
It's cool, obviously. You can see that. And now we do something with sparkling sugar. I've never heard of this.
Sparkling sugar is a party. I feel like
it's a party in a plate. I like it.
It's like jazz hands for cookies. So you're going to really roll heavily coat the log in it, right? One thing you want to do, if you left the log in the freezer for more than an hour, this puppy, because of all of the butter in it, will get rock hard, like super, super solid. So you're going to want it to come a little closer to room temperature when you cut it.
Oh, okay.
Like not totally warm temperature, but you get what I'm saying.
Could you run the knife under hot water? Or would it make it too soft in the buttery part of it?
It might make it a little too soft.
Okay.
But so then we're going to do a very generous, this is perfect, the consistency of this.
It looks good.
So we do a generous half inch cookie.
Oh, that's good.
That's beautiful.
So you slice it so easy.
So that's right.
And that makes all the
crystallized.
Yeah.
I guess doing it like this in the log makes all the slices and all the sizes kind of uniform, which is nice too. If you're making it for a holiday
party
or something.
Like those slice and bakes, but better.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yes. It's a homemade slice and bake.
And I love the texture that the sugar adds on the outside.
The crunch.
I know. It's beautiful too.
And it's beautiful.
And can you get sparkling sugar? You can get anywhere?
Yeah.
Is that a specialty thing?
They have it at grocery stores. stores. You can order it online.
Okay.
And the cool thing about sparkling sugar is it's not going to melt in the oven. So it keeps that pretty gorgeous shape.
Oh, okay.
These are not gonna spread much. So when you put them on your baking sheet, just leave, I like to leave a little bit of space because you want that heat circulating around it while it bakes.
Okay, but before the heat, that then goes back in the fridge, correct?
You're gonna put this in the fridge or the freezer, whichever you have space. And you wanna do that so that it maintains its shape while it bakes, because you have all that butter in there, and then when it hits the hot oven, it just wants to melt.
Right,
okay. Yeah.
So,
perfect.
And how long do they bake for?
They bake at 350 for 14 minutes.
Okay.
So we're gonna fast forward.
All right.
Here we go.
TV manager,
and they're substantial cookies. They're very good.
Yeah. Wow. It is substantial. Bite might not have been the best name for this cookie.
Yeah, these are not bites. These are pancakes.
No. So here we have our cookie. You can still see the sparkling sugar on it. And then what
that would be good
do,
just like that.
Yeah.
They are good just like that.
I mean, then we make them even better.
Yeah.
We dip them in dark chocolate.
So you can't do it like this, and we just spoon some on and smear it around.
Oh, that is wonderful. Okay, now as we do that, I have to ask you, you are a big Hallmark Channel movie fan, aren't you?
Yes, absolutely.
Especially during the holidays, I'm sure.
Yes.
And these would be perfect to make, and you can sit and watch and then snuggle up on the couch and eat them and enjoy all of Hallmark Channel Christmas movies. And there are going to be so many new ones over the next 2 weeks, but you can even start today, because later today there's going to be A Bride for Christmas with Andrew Walker. He's actually going to be here tomorrow. And there's A Wish for Christmas with our girl Lacey Chabert. And of course, it wouldn't be Christmas without Candace Cameron Bure. In A Christmas Detour. We are so excited to watch all of these and, of course, enjoy these fabulous cookies. Now, we can't leave before you talk a little bit about adding the last finishing touch.
Okay, so then you put a couple little, after you dip it in the chocolate, you put a couple little drops of the white chocolate and then smear it around in a circular motion.
And you got to let them cool again, don't you?
You need to let them sit and set, and that'll take a couple hours.
So in the refrigerator.
You can just leave them out on the countertop. They should be fine.
Unless you live in a really hot area.
Unless you live in like the desert or something.
They're beautiful.
Swirl and have a bite.
Go ahead, do it, Larissa.
Yeah, you got that swirl.
You're a cookie decorating pro.
Oh, look how pretty that is. You can't really mess up, which is what I like.
No,
excuse my hands, because I need a bite. Ready?
There you go.
I feel like if you're, are you going to do it?
Don't leave me hanging.
Okay.
Cheers. Let me try.
Right. Oh. What is that?
Oh, that is good. That is so soft and gooey.
And gooey.
Oh,
that's a perfect word for it.
Thank you
so much, Rebecca.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
For more from Rebecca, you can visit her website below. And for the full recipe, you can go to HallmarkChannel.com.